What's up guys, Ziovo here and welcome to a brand new video on the channel. Now in today's video, I'm going to be talking about my favorite 15 pieces of software that I feel like everybody should download right now. I'm going to start off by briefly going over 10 different programs and then I'm going to dive deeper into my top 5 favorite, overall covering 15 different free programs that I feel like at the end of the day, you guys will also enjoy, and hopefully by the end of this video, you'll find one or two that you want to download as well. Now before we begin, make sure to leave a like down below and let me know down below in the comments what your favorite current free software is. And with that being said, let's get started. Now, I'm assuming a lot of you guys clicked on this video because you have a new computer and you're looking for different software to download. So the first website I would recommend is called Ninite. And basically, it's a website where you can download a bunch of different software at once. It can be very common software like Skype or GIMP, or it can be more uncommon software. But you know, it's really good if you buy a new computer because you can download like 20 different pieces of software at once. Now, the first, you know, runners up I'm going to be talking about are going to be all of the graphic design, photo editing, video editing software. So the first one I'm going to talk about is Blender, and Blender is a 3D editing tool in which you can make lots of amazing 3D renders and animations, as well as YouTube intros, as you can see by doing a quick search on YouTube. Now, in terms of photo editors, I would have to say the best ones are GIMP and paint.net, and both of these are Photoshop alternatives which are very, very robust. And there's also one called Inkscape. Now, if you're looking for more of a drawing tool, a free one would be something called Krita, and it's completely free to download and you can use it as a drawing tool. And if you're looking for video editing, I would recommend DaVinci Resolve. Once again, it's free, but it does have a slight learning curve, but that's with every, you know, robust video editing software. But that pretty much sums it up for anything involving graphic design or online media editing. Now, in terms of different tech software, the first two softwares I'm going to be talking about are going to be productivity ones, and they're full Office suites. So if you don't want Microsoft Office, you can always get something called LibreOffice, which has all the functionality. I used this on my Chromebook with Linux like years back, and I remember it was so good. And then there's another alternative called OpenOffice, which also has all the different programs just renamed, but they work just like Microsoft Word, Excel, PowerPoint. Now, if you're looking to edit code, the two most popular ones are Notepad++ and Sublime Text. I personally prefer Sublime Text just because of the aesthetic. I don't code too much, but they both have their own distinct features and are great depending on the purpose. But now let's get into the actual top 5 free software that I feel like everybody should have on their computer. Now, I'm not going to make you wait till the very end to give you guys my number one recommendation, because my absolute free software that like changed my life is one called F.Lux or Flux. I'm sure a lot of you guys have heard of it before, but if you haven't heard of it, I would highly recommend you download it. Basically, what this software is that it adjusts the saturation and the lighting of your screen so that you can actually adjust the tint so that your computer is less strainful on your eyes. And when you first change it, you're going to be like, wow, why is my screen so orange? But once you start using it, you're not going to notice it anymore and your eyes are going to feel a lot less strained. This is really good if you're going to be someone who's editing at night. But when other people do look at your computer, it will look weird to them. But trust me, within a day, you'll adjust and you cannot go back once you download Flux. Now, while Flux is something I would recommend for everybody, the second software on this list isn't really for everybody, but if you're someone who likes reading, I would highly recommend you download a free software called Calibre on calibreebook.com. Basically, it's a software that allows you to manage all of your ebooks, but it also serves as a place to keep them all, as well as read them wherever you are. And for a software that does everything and being absolutely free, this is my favorite ebook software. Now, I've made a lot of videos about this third piece of software, but I would still put it on this list, and that is going to be Open Broadcaster Software, or also known as OBS. Now, the reason I like OBS so much is because of the versatility you have with it. Now, OBS is at its heart a screen recording software and a streaming software, so you can, you know, record videos for YouTube as well as stream to Twitch. But what's really cool about the software is the fact that it allows you to add different audio streams, so I could connect my mic as well as have the computer audio, and I can also have various screens and layers of video as well. So I could already have my face cam and background recording at the same time and already have it in place. And at the end, it can make one video file. So for someone who's very new to editing and doesn't want to get into, you know, learning Sony Vegas or DaVinci, you can actually make a full video in OBS, because OBS can record your screen, your face cam, you can add a face cam border at the same time, it can record your mic, and everything will be in sync. And once you're done recording, you can upload it straight to YouTube, which I feel like a lot of people don't realize. And that's what makes this software really, really amazing and worthy of this list. Now, if you're someone who's always on your computer and you're always downloading different things, but then you realize your hard drive is getting filled up and you don't know why, a really good software to download would be something called Whiztree. Basically, what Whiztree does is it quickly locates all of the largest files and folders on your hard drive, and you'll know what you need to delete to clear up your computer and have the extra space you need to download whatever you want. And if you're still watching this video, the final piece of software I would recommend is one I'm using right now, and it is Audacity. And Audacity is great for anyone who wants to record or edit any kind of audio. And the reason I like it so much is because over the last 4 or 5 years, it's barely changed and it's very, very easy to use. But at the same time, for an audio software, it does everything you needed to do within a few clicks. And it's very, very easy to pick up if you're someone who wants to get into doing YouTube or recording videos or singing or anything with audio, which is a lot of different things. But that's about it for this video, guys. Hopefully you did enjoy it. Remember to let me know down below in the comments what your favorite free software is, because I'd love to read them and reply to all of you guys. But that's about it. If you guys did like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. And as always, thanks for watching. My name is Ziovo, and I'm signing out.